A 13th individual has been arrested in the death of Lisandro Guzman Feliz.
About Ronald Ureña, 29-year-old Bronx resident. He's charged with murder, manslaughter, gang assault, conspiracy, and criminal possession of a weapon. Now, as he was being walked, we asked him a few questions. He answered in Spanish. He said that he's innocent, that his sister, he asked his sister to take care of his daughter. He says that he doesn't know the others that were involved, and he claims not to be a Trinitarios gang member. Again, of course, the Trinitarios gang accused of committing the murder. Again, the 13th arrest, Ureña is listed in a second indictment filed in relation to the case. He was taken into custody earlier today in the Bronx around 6:15 p.m. We spoke to his mother just a few minutes ago. Let's take a listen to her reaction to the latest arrest in connection to her son's death.
I want to say thank you, Gab, for showing me in my eyes. After 2 days, church, pray to God to get a justice for my son. This is God working.
Again, Ureña, the latest arrest. Of course, Junior's death has become a symbol of innocent victims that have been killed by gangs here in the streets of the Bronx. He was brutally murdered in a case of mistaken identity. Now the latest arrest. Again, Ronald Ureña, a 29-year-old Bronx resident. Sources telling us that he's a suspected gang member. Also that right now they're looking for other people that might have been involved in Junior's death.
BBN, Jack Frost, what's up, party people? Alright, so there's been a 13th arrest in the Lisandro Guzman Feliz case. In his, I don't know what you want to call it. I say case on here, but we all know what it was. His name is Ronald Ureña. Ronald? R-O-N-A-L-D, Ureña. Ureña? 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 Okay. U-R-E-N-A. He's 29. He was charged with murder, manslaughter, gang assault, conspiracy, criminal possession of a weapon. He is the 13th person arrested in the 15-year-old's death in June. Now, just so we could get more of an understanding about what's actually going on here, I told y'all before, when I first started doing these videos on this particular situation, that they were going to the police and the city were going to go after the entire gang. So let's not lose focus on that. I want the police to go after the people who are involved with this particular crime. I want them to get those guys off the streets. Now, I'm not saying other people shouldn't be taken off the streets. I'm saying I want to make sure that this young man and his family, or at least his family, gets justice for what was done to this young man. If his family feels taking down the entirety of the gang is justice, I guess do that. But in my opinion, let's make sure we get everybody that is involved or was involved with this particular murder. Now, with that being said, unless they have this guy on camera, which I don't think that they do, although I have heard people come into the comment section and say that there was more people than has been arrested. Remember, there was 12 people initially arrested. Two of those people were not even at the scene. I've had people come into the comment section and say that they counted up to 20 different people. There's a good chance that this guy is one of those different people. And there is also a good chance that he drove one of the vehicles. As we all know, somebody's talking. Somebody has to be talking. For there to be so much time between the arrest of the 12th person and the arrest of this particular individual, somebody's talking. Maybe they're even setting each other up with phone calls. Who knows? But as of right now, this is the 13th individual that has been arrested in connection with the murder of Lisandro Guzman Feliz. And personally, I look to see more. If you listen to what the news broadcast on WPIX said was, is that this was in a second moment. The first guys already were indicted. This is from a second indictment. And I'm pretty sure that there's more people that they plan on arresting, in this second indictment. I'm pretty sure that there were more names that came up in this second indictment and not just Renard Urenas. So I'll try to keep y'all guys covered. Whenever I get information, I disseminate it. I'm not going to just make videos to make videos. It has to be new information. That's just the way that I operate. And with all that being said, now, just my opinion on this whole entire case, I'm still not comfortable with them not explaining why the young lady is all of a sudden not being mentioned in anything. I'm not comfortable with that. I need a better explanation than the one that we were currently given. I've said before, I think that this is a case that they need to cover on television. I've said this before. Some people disagree with me. You have a right to disagree with me, by the way. It's okay to disagree with me. But I think that this is a case that needs to be covered on television like they did with the O.J. Simpson case. This is a slam dunk. I don't see any reason in which why the DA would be against such a thing. This is a slam dunk. But I want to know why they are so sure that the young lady is not involved. Remember, one of the gang leaders sent a text or Instagram or a message to the family apologizing, saying it was they killed the wrong individual. I want to know why they felt like what was going on, why they felt someone needed to die in the first place. I want to know, how does the police know that that young lady had nothing to do with this? I think these things are important. I want to know. I'm not at this point saying it had to have been her, but I am saying I want to know how the police knows that she had nothing to do with it. That's what I want to know. Anyway, leave the comments down below, please. I want to know what y'all guys think about this. Very important. Everybody leave a comment. No matter which way you feel, one way or the other on the subject, please leave a comment. Y'all comments help me decide, you know, sometimes which information is the information that needs to be given out. I give all new information out. But if I make a video and it's obvious that what I'm trying to say isn't clear, I'll redo the video. So please, leave comments. I want to make sure that I'm giving the information in a way that it's easily digestible. Anyway, like, comment, subscribe, join the notification gang. Hashtag Bronx Bombers. Let's get it. I love y'all. Take care of each other. And that's all I got on this one. I'm out. If you like this video, please hit the like and subscribe button. If you would like to help dictate the direction that this channel takes, please leave a comment. All comments are appreciated, whether positive or negative. Thank you very much and enjoy your day. And remember, positive thoughts cause for positive things to happen. Let's get it.